Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the commencement exercises of the class of 2020 from Shamokin Area High School. Tonight's graduation is like no other. We will be sharing all graduation speeches virtually, and then we will see you at 6 p.m. tonight for the presentation of your diplomas. At this time, I ask at home that you please rise for the singing and playing of the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
It's now my privilege to introduce to the platform the salutatorian of the class of 2020, Nathan Grimes, for an address of welcome. Nate is the class president. He is the president of the AV department. He was a varsity starting quarterback this past season. He's also a dual enrollment student and 4 years in a row the lead of the musical. And he will be attending Penn State University in the fall for biomedical engineering.
Thank you, Mr. Hockenbrock. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the class of 2020's commencement ceremony. It is my honor and privilege to start the most unique graduation to ever take place here at Shamokin Area. As I look around into an empty auditorium, I'm reminded of what should have been. However, the emotions I feel right now aren't negative. In fact, they're quite the opposite. The last 3 months have been a testament to who we are as a class. The challenging, winding path, filled with uncertainty and failed expectations, we had to endure as a class almost derailed all of the hard work we've completed over the last 13 years. but we persevered. These trying times will certainly prepare us for life. We were given an early taste of life as an adult 3 months ago. We found out that plans can be permanently altered due to situations we have no control over. We often ask why things don't go as planned, but personally, I feel it's more important to find silver linings in every situation. For the first time in a long time, we were all able to stop and assess our lives. We saw that our end-of-the-year goals failed to materialize, and the closure we all desired to feel at this time of the year failed to occur. What I realized from the recent months of reflection is that failure is all right. We've been told our entire lives that failure isn't an option and is always cast in a negative light, but failure itself isn't bad. We live in a society where everyone has this subliminal pressure to be perfect, which can ultimately destroy the strongest ego when we fail. Failure is bad when you let it consume you, but it can be an excellent teacher. I was a captain of the football team this past fall, and more often than not, found myself in high-pressure situations. In the biggest game of the year, I threw the game-losing interception. Victory was only 13 yards away, and ultimately, I failed in that situation. The following 24 hours could be something compared to hell on earth. People who I'd never met were defining my character as a human being based on one play from a game. That was obviously a very difficult situation for me to go through, and it genuinely bothered me for months. Yet, I was able to find the silver linings in a horrible situation and became a stronger person because of it. The game of football, as difficult and violent as it may be, shares numerous similarities with life. Life is a difficult game that has a way of destroying expectations, and it can slam you down regardless of how good or bad things have been going. Despite life's difficulties, it's important to find the positives in a negative situation. So how do we do that? When you're faced with a difficult situation, take a moment to breathe. If you have to make a big decision, sleep on it. Don't act in the heat of the moment, and take some time to remove yourself from the situation to approach it from a fresh perspective. Don't be afraid to lose yourself in the moment when things are good. Soak up every moment that you can with your friends and family. Life is a game, but believe it or not, you can win. Set goals for yourself. Write them down. Speak them into existence. If you fail at your goal, don't become discouraged. Realize why you failed, do what you can to set yourself up for success, and go for it. Don't give up on your dream, but do fight for your happiness. We think too much and feel too little. This was a quote from silent film star Charlie Chaplin in the film The Great Dictator. It's vital in the next phase of our lives that we don't let failure dictate how we live, but that we embrace it and use it as fuel to better ourselves. Don't surrender your minds to your thoughts. Instead, live in the moment, because we only have one life to live. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2020.
Thank you, Nate. On Monday evening, we held our virtual Senior Scholastics Award program, and over 50 students were awarded approximately $350,000. And at this time, it is my pleasure to share the award recipients for the class of 2020. Elena Russell, Rachel Shader, Daniela Herrera Chavez, Abby DiOrio, Jonathan Washuda, Wolfgang Pearson, Sophie Rosnock, Joey Mosser, Abigail Dawes, Matthew Bellis, Emma Laughlin, Emma Tomcavage, Holly Fagley, Angelina Schaefer, Kevin Markowski, Rhiannon Vlock Kogut, Nathan Grimes, Jack Sarace, Cherie Martin, Emily Slanina, Abby Jo Rodman, Emma Daly, Molly Stevens, Maggie Bowers, Jasmine Scandal, Caitlin Dunn, Cheyenne Moore, Raven DePeel, Casey Kalinowski, Blake Markowski, Jasmine Slodisco, Cheyenne Wolf, Matthew Mosser, Ariana Manley, Kayla Yadolski, Ashley Ponatusky, Blake Kane, Lily Avens, Matthew Shikitano, Nick Zimmerman, Caitlin Zawalik, Gabe Burns, Oceana Apollo, Madeline Donahue, Danielle Hinkle, Catherine Slaughterback, Isabel Stinkevich, Joshua Dombrowski, Shen Yeager, and Chloe Yoder. Ladies and gentlemen, the awards recipients for the class of 2020. Congratulations to all award winners. Each year, our senior class president, vice president, and secretary are given an opportunity to speak during the commencement program about the graduating class. Tonight, our class president will be speaking about the past, our class vice president will be speaking about the present, and our class secretary will be speaking about the future of the class of 2020. At this time, our class president, Nathan Grimes, will be speaking about the past of the class of 2020.
Thank you, Mr. Hockenbrock. Good evening, everyone. I'd like to take a moment to thank the school board, administration, faculty, and staff for making tonight possible. Thank you to our class advisors, Mrs. Rosnock and Mrs. Nockadil, for providing overwhelming support and inspiration over the course of the past 4 years. I would also like to thank all family members of the senior class for getting the students to this day, a day we have all dreamed of and anticipated for the past 13 years. Finally, I would like to thank the senior class for your hard work, determination, and resilience. I've been to the past 4 graduations as part of the AV Club, and every class president's speech included mentions of cookie concerts and memories made throughout elementary school. Unlike the previous presidents, I didn't go to Shamokin for kindergarten and elementary school. My time at Shamokin began in the awkward years of middle school, but I'm certain we've all shared similar experiences throughout our formative years of schooling. 13 years of learning, friendships, and opportunities have propelled us along our own journey of personal development. It started in kindergarten, where our guardian said goodbye and for the first time in our childhood, left us alone with someone they didn't know. Some of us were excited, some of us were terrified, but none of us truly knew what journey we were embarking upon. We learned the alphabet and how to count and soon experienced friendship. The foundation of our knowledge was established as those early days of our schooling nudged us forward. Kindergarten was followed by elementary school. Early years of elementary school reflected the kindergarten experience with a continued focus on arts and crafts. As elementary school went on, however, there was a clear tonal shift of teaching. We began to learn how to read and write, and we were expected to do work outside of the classroom. Looking back on it, I had a terrible time with understanding the concept of homework. Story time with our teacher was soon replaced with difficult math problems, and arts and crafts was replaced with science projects. During the later years of elementary school, we started the process of discovering ourselves. Our self-awareness expanded as we looked forward to bigger and better things. My time at Shamokin began in middle school, and it was such a new experience. My anxiety of going to a new school skyrocketed when I saw that no one was carrying a lunchbox into school. I must have missed the memo, but apparently that wasn't the cool thing to do. First impressions matter, guys. The idea of AR points were new, and all I can say is, thank goodness I never have to read 200 pages of a novel the day before points are due again. We finally had a taste of freedom. We could go to lunch without following a teacher. No silent lunches, study halls, and downtime in class were the highlights of day-to-day life in middle school. We formed bonds with teachers and were able to take advantage of new opportunities through clubs, sports, and the arts. We were treated with talent shows before Christmas and Hershey trips at the end of the year. The weeks following our eighth grade formal were filled with excitement for the summer, but the prospect of being a high school student was both exciting and terrifying. We were still trying to figure out who we were and who we wanted to be, ready to begin the final leg of our journey. Walking into Shamokin as a freshman felt new. Previous graduates had warned that the next 4 years would be the quickest of my life, but I naively disregarded that advice. We all had to adjust to the loss of SSR and the bewildering idea that teachers weren't going to stay on your back if you didn't hand in your work on time. As a high school student, we had the privilege of being a member of the student section. Class scheduling and intriguing classes were now available to us. Sports, clubs, concerts, talent shows, musicals, and prom were a big part of our high school experience. Some students struggled, others flourished, but we've made it to this day. Congratulations to my fellow members of the class of 2020. In closing, we've run out of time on the final leg of our high school journey. We have evolved into individuals with our own unique self-identity. It is time to continue a lifelong journey of discovering our talents and developing them. The future is bright, and as I learned in middle school, it's important to remember that first impressions matter. I'll leave you with a quote from Mark Twain. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails. Explore, dream, discover.
Thank you, Nate. Next, our class vice president, Chloe Yoder, will be speaking about the present. Chloe is a track and field athlete and will be attending Susquehanna University to major in psychology.
Good evening, members of the school board, administration, faculty, family, friends, and fellow classmates of the class of 2020. To begin, I would like to say thank you to our class advisors, Mrs. Rosnock and Mrs. Knockadale, for everything they have done to make today possible, and to the faculty and staff for providing us with a wealth of knowledge and resources to help guide us in the right direction for success. The class of 2020 is extraordinary. Throughout high school, we envisioned our graduation to be like ceremonies of the past, except that it will finally be our turn to feel the excitement. Although we cannot celebrate together, be proud of how strong we have been to get through an unprecedented time in history. Our staff and the community have gone above and beyond to show us compassion and to make sure we know that we are important and cared for in a way like no other. As we take our final walk through the halls as a Shamokin area high school student to receive our diplomas, take in all of the memories one last time. Whether you have been at Shamokin area since kindergarten, junior high, or high school, congratulations on your wonderful achievement. As we take our next step into the future, whether it be college, heading into the workforce, or serving for our country, I am proud of each and every one of you for the amount of effort you have put into the past 13 years. I know you all will continue to do great things with the paths you have chosen for your future. Every individual in this class has contributed to the amazing memories that we shall hold on to for a lifetime. Keep those memories safe, as they have had a big impact throughout your childhood and teenage years. As the great Dr. Seuss once said, sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. This is our moment, our chance to make one more memory here at Shamokin area. Make it your most memorable one. Today is the day we say our last goodbye to the place that has been our home away from home. With our heavy emotions, as we close this chapter of our lives and prepare for the next, thank the ones around you as they have watched you grow and have helped shape you into the person you are today. To my fellow Indians, if only you could just have 5 more minutes. Thank you and congratulations to the Shamokin area class of 2020.
Thank you, Chloe. And finally, the class secretary, Sophie Rosnock, will be speaking about the future of the class of 2020. Sophie is a dual enrollment student. She was the captain of the soccer and basketball team, member of the track and field team, class secretary, student council president, member of the varsity club, daily item scholar athlete of the week, and attending Lock Haven University for sports administration.
Good evening, members of the school board, administration, faculty, family, friends, and fellow classmates. I would like to thank Mrs. Rosnock and Mrs. Nockadil for all the hard work they put into making these past 4 years unforgettable. We finally did it. Today is a day we have looked forward to for almost all our lives. After tonight, a new chapter will finally begin. Most of us already know where we are headed, whereas others may not. Some will dread it, and others will be thrilled to start something new. Steve Jobs once said, "You cannot connect the dots looking forward, you can only connect them looking backwards." So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something, your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Looking back at this class, there are so many people with a chance to succeed. Whether it be college, the workforce, the army, or some of us who are not quite sure what we are doing just yet. Shamokin area has prepared us to be able to handle whatever life throws at us. With that being said, the future is in our hands now. It is all up to us. Now it is our time to find ourselves. I wish you all luck in whatever you choose to do. Our senior year did not exactly end how we wanted it to. We are not like any other seniors. We did not get to experience the fun the last 3 months of high school, but overall this will make us stronger. Hopefully these circumstances have helped us to realize that we should never take anything for granted. Although letting go of the past is scary, we are on to new things now. We will forever be grateful for the amazing friendships, knowledge, and experiences Shamokin area has given us. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Thank you, Sophie. Before we continue with the next part of our program, I would like to acknowledge the class advisors, Ms. Sandy Rosnock and Ms. Donna Nockadil. The graduation advisors, Ms. Linda Venn and Ms. Christine Alonzo, and all other faculty and staff members who have helped prepare for graduation and this evening's exercises, and most of all, you, the families of the graduates, watching at home tonight. Tonight, I would like to talk to the senior class about two themes: facing adversity and resiliency. Your senior year was cruising along when you were faced with adversity, the COVID-19 pandemic. Schools were closed, we were all quarantined to our houses, education took place online, you were not able to even socialize with your friends personally. Prom was postponed, times of counting down your final days at Shamokin area were robbed from you. Your story couldn't be more horrid for a senior. When faced with adversity, humans have two choices to make. They can quit and lay down, or they can face it head on and attack it like a warrior with no fear. The class of 2020 are warriors. You did not lie down and go quietly into the night. You faced your adversity and you accepted it for what it was. You got knocked down but rose back to your feet to fight and conquer this adversity. There are times in life when you are challenged and you need to respond. The way you responded speaks volumes about your character and who you are as a person. Life lessons are never planned. They come at you when you least expect it. In your young life, you have gained the experience of a life lesson that will carry you throughout your life. You have learned how to deal with things out of your control. For example, to have your perfect senior vision skewed. If there is one thing that I want you to take from this, is you never lose, as in lose your senior year or lose the prom. You embrace the situation and learn from the experience. If you go through life understanding that simple statement, you can find light in the darkest times. You have learned to adapt and overcome. You had a choice to feel sorry for yourself or to deal with it and do what needed to be done. This obstacle was put in your life for a reason. Will you let adversity break you, or will you use it to strengthen you? Adversity can make you strong if you learn from it. However, it can also crush you if you let it. Life's limitations can sometimes inspire us to strive for heights we may not have otherwise reached. Sometimes we also need to look into things in another context. You're healthy. You're alive, you're young, you have your whole life ahead of you yet, you're resilient. When you look at unfortunate events that people have to face, like the loss of a loved one or losing everything in a fire, you begin to realize what we're going through isn't that bad. There is always someone that has to deal with something more than you. That doesn't justify just laying down and playing victim. It simply means we all have to face our own challenges in life. You need to have faith in the process of learning to overcome obstacles in life. Some have to learn early in life. Some of us are not challenged until later in life. No matter the time in your life that you are challenged, it's how you respond to the challenge. Stare it down, stand tall, and take charge. Never ask why this happens, but embrace the challenge and learn from it and become a stronger and better person. The class of 2020 is an inspiration to all future classes. You will always be remembered for the challenge you were faced with. Your peers will see how you move forward in the face of adversity. You are role models for future generations of students that may be faced with adversity. They will always look to the class of 2020 as an inspiration. You have inspired everyone around you for not just dealing with the situation, but conquering it. You took COVID-19 and made it a part of your life story. You took what the universe threw at you and made it a learning experience to become stronger and smarter. In a few moments, your names will be announced and you will walk across the stage like no other student here at Shamokin Area High School has ever done. You will hold your head high with courage and smile in victory because you have achieved the first of many lifelong goals. Your family will embrace you and celebrate your success. Thank them. They have been there for you the entire time. Now that we are on the downside of this pandemic, also don't forget to take the time to embrace your friends and people that have been there as your inspiration. Class of 2020, I've never been more proud of anyone. Let's close this final chapter of your high school careers and make a vow to use this experience to move on and be as great as we can be as human beings. I'll see you soon with excitement and honor of presenting you with your diplomas. Mr. Venna, as principal of Shamokin Area High School, I hereby certify that these members of the class of 2020 have met all graduation requirements established by the Pennsylvania Department of Education and the Shamokin Area Board of Education, and are therefore entitled to receive their high school diploma as evidence of this achievement.
Mr. Hockenbrock, I officially accept the class of 2020. I would first like to start off by saying that in my 20 years plus in education, I would never have imagined what we have all gone through during these past several months. I recognize that in our school, every student and staff member has been affected. But my heart goes out especially to you, the class of 2020. Most of this class was born during the year of 9/11, one of the most significant times in the history of our great country, and it changed the world we know. And today, here you are, embarking on a new chapter of your life, once again in the midst of another unprecedented time, a pandemic that once again has changed the world we know. These past 2 or 3 months were supposed to be a time filled with memorable moments and experiences enjoyed with your classmates, teachers, and friends. I am sure you all struggled with the reality that your senior year wasn't going to end how you pictured it. But in the words of Albert Einstein, in the middle of every difficulty lies opportunity. And you, the class of 2020, have certainly made this your opportunity. You've had to keep your minds occupied while staying at home during a time when you normally would have been making memories. You've had to find new ways to get your schoolwork done and complete your graduation requirements remotely. You've had to become more creative in the ways you communicate with your teachers, your guidance counselors, and classmates. And you've had to make time to process all of the different emotions and thoughts that come along with high school graduation. With that being said, the one thing I've learned about this group through all of this is that the strength and resilience of this class is unmatched by any other to walk the halls of Shamokin area. What's ironic about all this is that by having your traditional memorable moments modified or stripped away from you during this time, you all have had the most memorable ending to a senior year than any other group, one that you will certainly never forget. As a class, you face this adversity as one. And as you all continue to get through this, it has made you even stronger as a class, because you truly have been all in all of this together. To me, that speaks volumes about your character, your toughness, and your ability to adapt to change, all qualities and skills that you have learned during your time here at Shamokin area. So in closing, I first want to say thank you. Thank you for sticking together as a class and adapting to what many of us call the new normal. You are truly an amazing group. And secondly, I want to offer the class two very simple pieces of advice. One, work hard at whatever it is you do in life, because there is no substitute for hard work. And two, no matter what you do, don't ever forget where you came from, now more so than ever. Your memories, your experiences, and the connections you've made here at Shamokin area will follow you for the rest of your lives. Be proud of that. Congratulations, class of 2020.
At this time, I'll call upon the class treasurer, Emma Lachlan, for the presentation of the class gift. Emma is our current valedictorian. She's a class treasurer, was a participant of the volleyball team, the track and field team, also vice president of the National Honor Society, the treasurer of student council, the treasurer of the varsity club, math club, and chemistry club. She was also a dual enrollment student and will be attending Westchester University for actuarial sciences.
Good evening, fellow classmates, family, friends, faculty, administrators, and members of the school board. We did it. I could not have asked for a better class to graduate with. It is finally our time to move on and show the world what we can do. I would like to thank Mrs. Rosnock and Mrs. Nockadil for all of the hard work they put into making the past 4 years so memorable for us. For our class gift, we have purchased televisions to be mounted in the gymnasium lobby. These televisions will show what is going on inside of the gym during the events that we hold, along with highlights of all of our sports and athletes, and display schedules for upcoming events. At this time, we will present a check to Mr. Hockenbrock. Mr. Hockenbrock, would you please step forward to accept the class gift?
Thank you. It is now my privilege to introduce to the platform the valedictorian of the class of 2020, Emma Laughlin, to deliver the valedictory address.
Thank you, Mr. Hockenbrock, and good evening, members of the school board, administration, faculty, family, friends, and the class of 2020. Words cannot even describe the honor I am feeling to be giving this speech today. First of all, I would like to thank all of my teachers who have pushed me to be where I am today, from constantly messing around in Mr. Major's room to getting relationship advice from Mrs. Schaefer. You are all more than just teachers, but friends. Education is truly the most important thing you could give to anyone, and being able to educate someone while also always being there for them is something amazing, so I thank you all for that. Another thing that put me here is the constant motivation from my parents. The calls from my dad every single night, or my mom asking me if I had homework, although annoying at times, was really just them showing how much they cared. I did not understand that part until I got the news that I was the valedictorian and saw the tears streaming down their faces. So I would also like to thank them for always being there and always caring. None of us graduating would have been able to do it without the support from everyone here today. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. This is the one saying that really describes the class of 2020. We've been through more hardship than any other past classes have. To begin, we were born around 9/11, which was some of the toughest times America has endured. Additionally, there were budget cuts, political issues, and many more hardships. Finally, our senior year ended so abruptly due to a global pandemic. It has never really been easy for us, but we've always found a way to make lemonade. We will move on from Shamokin area to college, the military, or the workforce. But the one thing that we will leave here with is the ability to handle whatever life throws at us. There are so many good things to come out of this town, but sometimes we do not notice them until the hard times. Everything the school has done for this class, along with the community, such as Mars Dairy doing free breakfast for students and the Senior Adoption Facebook page, they all mean more to us than words can say. These kind of things need to happen all the time, not just when something bad happens. Now it is up to us, the class of 2020, to take everything we have learned and apply it to the rest of our lives. Learn to find the positives and make people feel good even when they're not hurting or in need. You may not always get what you want, things will not always go your way, but the way you adapt and overcome says a lot about you as a person. Through all the things we have been through, this class has always been able to lean on each other. As you move on to the rest of your life, make sure you find your people to lean on. Our time here at Shamokin Area has come to a close. It is up to you now to make lemonade out of lemons. And now, as you walk across the stage, after you receive your diploma, join me in the ceremonial gesture of graduation and move your tassel from the left side to the right side. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2020.
Thank you, Emma. Now I'm going to ask you to do something else that's never been done here at Shamokin Area High School, but we're going to sing our alma mater. And I ask that all of you watching this ceremony tonight stand up, put your arms around each other, and join us all in singing our alma mater.
Alma mater, dear, we sing to you with devotion deep and true. Your colors, bright, the purple and white, will stir our hearts anew. Shamokin Area High School, we give thanks and honor due. Though changes come, as time rolls on, we'll always be loyal and true.
We'll begin our presentation of diplomas at 6 p.m. This evening, Mr. Weller will be reading the names of our graduates. And presenting diplomas this evening is Mr. Brian Persing, our board president of Shamokin Area School District. Please drive safely to the school, and remember, you may bring along with you 4 family members to join you tonight in this special occasion. Everyone must wear a mask until they enter the auditorium. You will park in the student parking lot and wait for our security to allow you to exit your car. Please make sure to follow all directions and signs once entering campus. This concludes the virtual portion of our graduation. Thank you, and I'll see you soon.
Elbow. Welcome to the presentation of the diplomas for the Shamokin Area Class of 2020. Rachel Lynn Kerstetter. Logan Thomas Williams. Jared Green. Abigail Kirsten Kiefer. Nathan William Grimes. Nathan will be attending Penn State University for biomedical engineering. Chloe Eden Yoder. Chloe will be attending Susquehanna University for psychology. Sophie Catherine Rosnock. Sophie will be attending Lock Haven University for sports administration. Emma Irene Laughlin. Emma will be attending Westchester University for actuarial science. Sean M. Seddon. Sean will be entering the workforce after graduation. Destiny Kaylee Zimmerman. Destiny will be attending Mansfield University in the fall.
Just making sure the light's right. Just making sure the light's in my face.
Cheyenne Stesha Moore. Cheyenne will be attending Cedar Crest College for nursing. Margaret Elizabeth Bowers. Maggie will be attending Susquehanna University in the fall for pre-law and psychology. Caitlin Rose Zawalik. Caitlin is attending Cedar Crest College for secondary education. Tiffany Marie Klayman. Tiffany will be attending Luzerne County Community College in the fall.
I'll clean up. football player. Don't forget we're on camera.
I know.
Bianca Marie Cotterall. Bianca will be joining the workforce after graduation. Joshua Anthony Dombrowski.
Congratulations, Josh. Awesome job.
Congratulations. Stand here on that spot.
Josh will be attending Wilkes University for biochemistry and pre-med.
Congratulations.
Congrats, Josh. Remember, they had this wrong.
Brianna Lynn Knoll. Brianna will be a Raider at Shippensburg University. Elena Rose Bendis. Elena will also be a Raider attending Shippensburg University for social work.
Need a crowbar to separate them. Yeah.
Can you type notes into there to them? Tell them to remind the people to follow the dots. I don't know what the heck they're doing. There's Jack. Go ahead.
Okay. Samantha Renee Martinez.
Congrats, Sam.
Do me a favor.
Samantha will be entering the workforce upon graduation. David Lee Thomas. In the fall, Dave plans on attending Independence College. Andrew Jacob Nelson. Andrew will be joining the workforce after graduation.
If you trip, we laugh. It's all good. It's all good. It's all good. Cyber kid. I know. We're only kidding.
Go ahead.
April R. Regal. April will be attending college in the fall.
Yep, okay.
Charity J. Regal. Charity will be attending college in the fall. Jack Elijah Cerase.
Congratulations, Jack.
Hey, you know, you got the principal prize.
Yeah, there's a check in your diploma. Yeah, there's a check in your diploma.
Jack will be joining the workforce in the fall.
Oh, is it really? Ready?
Emily Ann Slanina. Emily will be attending Lebanon Valley College for physical therapy.
That's awesome. Ready?
Okay. Caitlin Alexis Dunn.
Congratulations.
Caitlin will be attending Lock Haven University for sports administration. Connor Kenneth Nye. Connor will be attending college in the fall. Emma Jean Tomcavage. Emma will be attending Bloomsburg University for criminal justice.
I like the tie. You look really sharp.
Matthew Joseph Chicatano. Matthew will be attending Bloomsburg University.
You never got as small as his dad, no?
Joseph Robert Lee Mosser. Joseph will be attending Susquehanna University in the fall.
Congratulations.
It's going to be the same family.
Yearbooks turned out great. Same family, ready?
Same family.
Okay.
Matthew Glenn Mosser. Matthew will be attending Susquehanna University this fall. Rhiannon Patricia Kogut. Rhiannon will be attending Luzerne County Community College this fall. Matthew Thomas Bellis. Matt will be attending Wilkes University for nursing. Caitlin Marie Lukowski. Caitlin will be attending Empire Beauty School. Devin Kane Elliott. Devin will be attending college this fall. Dennis Joseph Cole, Jr. Dennis will be attending Rosemont College for history. Gabriel Alexander Burns. Gabe will be attending the Pennsylvania College of Technology for physician's assistant. Jacob Allen Alvord. Jacob will be attending the workforce after graduation. Danielle Isabel Herrera Chavez. Daniela will be joining the workforce after graduation. Ashley Jane Ponitoski. Ashley will be a River Hawk at Susquehanna University studying biomedical science. Sarah Renee Bainey.
Yay for you.
Sarah will be attending Bloomsburg University in the fall. Kayla Marie Moore. Kayla will be attending Empire Beauty School.
Congratulations.
Holly Anna Fegley. Holly will be attending Kutztown University studying pre-law. Abby Elizabeth DiOrio. Abby is off to Cedar Crest College to study nursing. Emma Elizabeth Daly. Emma will be attending Cleveland Institute of Art for Illustration and Game Design. Casey Joy Kalinowski. Casey will be studying college in England for music theater. Jacob Levi McCown. Jacob will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Congratulations. Ariana Lizetta Manley. Ariana is joining the workforce after graduation.
Double checking your credits. No, I'm kidding. Okay, you get it. You ready? Okay.
Tori Elizabeth Moser.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Tori, congratulations.
Thank
Stand
you.
On the spot there. Look at the camera. Move your posture.
Tori is joining the workforce upon graduation.
Jason Forreys and Michael Rogers.
I bet EOC lost his mind when he seen him.
Destiny Hope Jones.
Congratulations. Make sure you stand on the dot.
Destiny is off to Cedar Crest College to study nursing. Skylar Jordan McKinney. Skylar is off to the workforce upon graduation.
Congratulations. Go ahead.
There he comes.
Is this him?
Yeah.
Oh, that's freaking great.
Jace Fagerstrom.
Hi, Jace. Congratulations.
Hi, Jace.
Yes.
Here, buddy. Come here.
Jace is off to work foundations in the fall. Jaron David Fagerstrom.
Hi,
Jaron is off to the workforce upon graduation. Desir K. Lovelace. Desir is off to the workforce upon graduation. Abigail Nicole Cherries. Abby will be attending Empire Beauty School in the fall. Alyssa Kelly Snyder. Alyssa is off to the Navy upon graduation. Kayla Elizabeth Pikevich. Kayla will be attending Empire Beauty School this fall. Sierra Lee Neidig. Sierra is attending Luzerne County Community College in the fall. Michaela Olivia Morosky. Michaela is off to college this fall. Logan Robert Williams.
Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you.
Just stand there and move your tongue.
Logan will be entering the workforce upon graduation.
Probably the most athletic kid that's ever
really
played a sport.
Yeah, yeah, really.
Basketball.
Yeah.
Basketball. Soccer.
Yeah.
He was athletic. Who's this character? Bubba. Dude's got suspenders on that. Look at him. Look at the dude in the corner.
Awesome.
That is outstanding.
Bailey Elijah Wary. Bailey is off to the workforce upon graduation.
You don't have purple hair. Where's the white hair? All the driving me crazy.
Zanria Patience Brown. Zanria will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Kirsten Nicole Kaler. Kirsten is off to the workforce upon graduation. Hunter Scott Kerstetter. Hunter is off to Penn State for engineering. Mason Ryan Filarski. Mason will be joining the workforce upon graduation. Benjamin James Gink. Ben will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Jasmine Ann Scandal. Jasmine's off to Villanova University for biochemistry. Raven Elise McCafferty.
We're gonna miss you. Stand on the dot.
Raven will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Brandon Michael England. Brandon will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Savannah Lynn Smith. Savannah will be attending college in the fall. Kaylee Sage Kashinsky. Kaylee is off to Lock Haven University for social work. Andrew Varick Druckenmiller. Andrew is off to Pennsylvania College of Technology. Abigail Len Nicholson. Abby was entering the workforce upon graduation. Connor John Aniscavage. Connor is off to Wilkes University to study nursing. Blake Edward Markowski. Blake is off to the Pennsylvania College of Technology. Ryan Robert Nolan. Ryan is entering the workforce upon graduation. Molly Rebecca Stevens. Molly is off to Susquehanna University to study mathematics. Cherie Ann Martin. Cherie is off to the Rock, Slippery Rock University, to study philanthropy. Farah Jocelyn Crum. Farah is off to Bloomsburg University to study medical imaging. Giovanni McNeil Gibson. Giovanni is off to the Pennsylvania College of Technology.
Works at Wise's. Megan. Hold on.
Megan Rose Lewis. Megan is off to the workforce upon graduation. Jonathan Patrick Washuda. Jonathan is off to the University of Central Florida for mechanical engineering. Brian Lee Hornberger. Brian is off to East Stroudsburg University. Kalen Craig Herb. Kalen is off to college to study diesel mechanics. Thomas Riley Fiore.
Thomas, congratulations, buddy. Stand there and move your thoughts.
Tom is off to the workforce upon graduation.
Congratulations. Hey, look at this guy. Is Grandpa here? Is your doctor? What about that?
Hunter Paul Myers. Hunter is off to the workforce upon graduation. Joseph Michael Curran. Joe is off to the workforce upon graduation.
Congratulations, Joe.
Angelina Marie Schaefer. Angelina will be studying music at Mansfield University. Isabel Jade Sienkiewicz. Isabel is going to be a pharmacist studying at Wilkes University. Giovanni Percier.
Congratulations, man.
Gio is off to the workforce after graduation. Brandon Michael Huff.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Stand there and move
your hands. Brandon is entering the workforce. Nathan Alexander Persing. Nathan is off to the workforce after graduation. Victoria Odyssey Bravitz. Victoria is off to Cedar Crest College. River Gabriel Brabitz. River will be attending the workforce.
Congratulations.
Cheyenne Lynn Colross. Cheyenne will be continuing her education in the cosmetology field. Shen Charles Yeager. Shen will be attending college in the fall. Bryce Robert Anderson. Bryce will be attending college in the fall.
That happens. Oops.
Amber Lynn Klinger.
Congratulations.
Amber will be attending the workforce. Catherine Susan Slaughterback.
Congratulations. Stand there and move your tassel.
Catherine is off to Manhattan College to study political science. Olivia Margaret Collier.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Liv is off to Luzerne County Community College. Dalton Vaughn Bauer. Dalton is off to the workforce. Madeline Grace Donahue. Madeline will be off to college. Alyssa Jane Schwartz. Alyssa will be off to college this fall. Cheyenne LaDawn Wolf. Cheyenne is off to Hobie Sound Bible College for elementary education. Tate Ryan Frederick. Tate joined the Navy. Jaheim S. Cruz. Jaheim will be off to college in the fall. Raven Lee DePeel.
Yeah.
Raven will be attending Temple University for theater, broadcast, and media production. Shane Michael Fawcett.
You did well in sight. You'll learn the deal. I'm proud of you.
Congratulations, buddy.
He actually passed.
Stand right here and move your tassel.
He passed without the ball.
Yeah?
Shane is off to the workforce. Thomas Raymond Horseman.
Congratulations, buddy. Just stand right there.
Thomas is off to the workforce. Susana Hernandez. Susana is off to Luzerne County Community College. Blake Lamar Hartzell.
Stand right there and move your tassel.
Blake will be entering the workforce. Travis William Zimmerman. Travis will be entering the workforce after graduation. Abby Jo Rodman. Abby will be studying nursing at Bloomsburg University. Blake Thomas Kane. Blake will be studying plastics and polymer engineering at Pennsylvania College of Technology. Bryson Alexander James. Bryson will be attending college this fall. Corey Robert Marufka. Corey will be studying automotive high performance at the University of Northwest Ohio. Yes. Talasia Cecile Schaefer. Talasia is off to Lock Haven University to study social work. Dylan Anthony Bainbridge. Dylan is off to the workforce upon graduation. Lily Ann Avens. Lily will be a fellow Panther at the University of Pittsburgh Swanson School of Engineering and studying chemical engineering. Sarah Grace Kratzer. Sarah is off to Triangle Tech. Cheyenne Marie Ducharme. Cheyenne plans to join the Army. Rachel Marie Shader. Rachel will continue her studies in the cosmetology field. Maya Zuzana Thompson. Maya will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Nicholas William Meisner. Nick will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Kevin Paul Markowski. Kevin will be off to Penn Tech for software development. Gabrielle Nicole Grieger. Gabby will be off to East Stroudsburg University. Wolfgang Marcus Pearson. Wolfie will be studying medical imaging at Bloomsburg University. Damian Joseph Bommerts. Damian will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Jasmine Marie Slidisco. Jasmine will be studying nursing at Wilkes University. James Thomas Mensch. James will be entering the workforce. Tessa Ray Bowman. Tessa is off to Luzerne County Community College. Abigail Paige Doss. Abby is joining the Wolf Pack at North Carolina State University, majoring in chemistry and minoring in biology. Paige Elizabeth Campbell. Paige is off to Bloomsburg University to study biological and allied health science. Megan Lynn Waiwatis. Megan is off to Thaddeus Stevens. Catherine Susan Slaughterback. Got it. Nope. Kyra Sanders. Kyra is off to Wilson College for equine studies. Joshua Allen Rich. Joshua will be entering the workforce. Madison Ann Lesher. Madison will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Zach Ryan Philhauer. Zach is off to the workforce. Janet Christine Coolish. Janet is off to the workforce. Alexandria Nicole Madison. Alexandria is off to the workforce. Hannah Dolores Smith. Hannah will be attending college this fall. Oceana Storm Apollo. Oceana will be a pirate at East Carolina University. Aurora Elaine Sky Skeens. Aurora will be attending college in the fall. Nicholas Ash Zimmerman. Nick will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Jonathan Near Rainier. T. Tia Alico Bressi. Tia will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Joseph Scott Jackson. Joseph is off to the National Guard. Kayla Lynn Yadlowski. Kayla is off to college this fall. Samantha Anna Ebersole. Samantha is off to Wilkes University. Danielle Marie Hinkle. Danielle will be entering the workforce. Zach Robert Moyer. Zach will be off to the workforce upon graduation. Caleb Arthur Steinberg. Caleb will be attending a trade school in the fall. Luis Antonio Rivera, Jr. Luis will be entering the workforce upon graduation. Garrett Thomas Smith. Congratulations. Good job. Garrett will be entering the workforce upon graduation.
You're good. Congratulations, Garrett.
Is that it?
Yeah, do you want to? I mean, I don't have time, but yeah. That's the last.
7:55.
What was the time? Were we 8 or we got 7:30? Or?
That concludes the presentation of the diplomas for the class of 2020.